Right, hello everyone, welcome back to Suikoden. I am SIMSteven, also known as Miss Fenril, and today we'll be exploring the Lorimar region in a bit further detail and all that. But first, we've got a few more recruits that I've missed, a couple I've forgotten about completely, and a few that I've avoided trying to get until now. First things first, I took out Kirkus and put Alan in my party because I did say he's a very good party member to have, and well, he'll help out in one of the fights we'll be doing real soon. Aside from that, there's one other person in an early area that I've forgotten about, even though I mentioned her in the last episode, by name, in fact, when we were doing the little card game. Lorelei, I think you have to be like level 30 in order to recruit her. We're way past that now. Let me see. Alright, you look 30, pretty tough. I'll join. You should be able to get high enough level once you reach Milish's domain, so yeah, easy recruit once you get that far in the game, but not when you first come here to get Lepant as a general in your army. Alright, and off screen I did some level grinding as well, so Tyr is now level 40 as you can see. So now I should be able to get Aikai, who's been hanging around in Recon, I believe that's the name of them. No, not Recon. I probably should have checked for Clive there, but oh well. It's not Recon. Recon's one to the south. Hold on until I remember which place I'm supposed to go to. And a bit of a burp there. So it's not Ante. It's not Recon. It must be Tien. Alright, there we are. So this guy was like, you're 12 levels short. Yeah, very exact number, but I believe at the time it would have been like level 40 if I did my math right. You're strong? Whoa, you are indeed. You're claiming my strength. I was waiting for someone like you. Let me join the Liberation Army. All right. Thanks. So he says thanks. So he's also similar to Pawn in that he uses claws and he punches people. He also comes with a rune known as a double beat rune, which when we get to Suikoden 2, I'm going to be grinding out a lot of those because they're one of the most useful runes to have in Suikoden 2. I don't even know if you can remove it from him in this game, but it basically allows him to attack twice in one turn. Very good for melee fighters, of course, if they're very strong in melee, but I wouldn't give it to someone like Victor, even if I could remove it. Simply because Victor's hit is so low and he could end up killing himself with counterattacks. Now, Ante. I actually did something off screen that I've been saying I would do for the past three episodes or so. And that was finally get that Opal. And I believe Esmeralda is here in this town. And we just need to go get that. Remember, we got to get that from the nightmares in Sonia Prison. And it took me like another 15 fights or so in order for me to finally get it to drop, which oddly enough I looked up the drop rate. It's like 2.6%, which is actually a pretty decently high drop rate. I just got very unlucky in getting that. Anyways, she's like, all right, now that you're acting in good faith, I'll come along. And she wants to be kidnapped and all that, so yeah. Still don't get her motives and all that, and still don't get why we had to go to all that trouble to recruit her. She's a very odd recruit in that, unlike a lot of the characters that pretty much become fighters when they have no real purpose, Esmeralda there pretty much has no purpose even after you recruit her. She's not a fighter. She doesn't provide like any sort of shop or anything. She just, you recruit her and she just sits in your castle and does nothing. So yeah, not a fan of her, what lengths you have to go to get her, and how useless of a character she is once you finally get her. So yeah, do not like that girl, don't really care for her, I just get her for completion's sake. Oh good, I was thinking she was going to be like Jabba and not actually take it out of your inventory, because that Nameless Urn was still in my inventory even after I recruited Jabba. But yeah, I had to stash it in the stashing place, or the vault between, I'm thinking of Grandia with stashing places, but I had to put the nail serum back in the vault, kind of like with the soap when I used to recruit Sarah. Anyways, we got three more recruits that I can get, and also one of the reasons why I did a bit of grinding. I should be okay with this fight, but for this fight you need to bring along Yamku and Taiho, and I recommend that you level them up a decent amount before you go and do this, because there's this little hut out in the middle of the ocean or the Lake Torn here, known as the Pirate's Fortress, and we went here once before, just kind of when we were exploring Lake Torin. Nothing big or nothing real fancy about what I was doing then, but I was kind of just exploring places and all that. We run the place around here. Hi there! And this guy. Hey, NG, you must be you're just wasting away. Why don't you give us a hand? Wasting away? Me? Watch your mouth. I'll show you who's wasting away. Get ready to fight. Alright, fight. Andy, alright then. Leonardo, Kinnick, don't pull any punches. I think you need both Taiho and Yamku for this fight, and this is also one reason why I brought Alan along. Because Alan has a Rage Rune, and I'm going to use Black Shadow, hit them all at once. I think Angie is the biggest threat. I think he has a rune on him, so you want to take him out first. The other guy is not so much, but Angie here. He has a Rage Rune. And we've seen Fire Rune spells before, and there is one spell that he does not have that is on the normal Fire Rune, and that is, I think, Fire Arrows. We've got Firestorm, Deathly Flames, and Explosions. This is already the level 4 spell on a Fire Rune. And there's one more after this that is on the Rage Rune, and that's why it is more an advanced rune. The first level spell on a Fire Rune, normal Fire Rune that is, gets removed, and there is actually a fifth level spell, but since there's only four levels of magic, well, the weakest one gets taken out, and level 2 now becomes level 1, level 3 becomes level 2, and so on and so forth. So, Explosion, we'll actually get to see the level 4, the level 4 spell of a Fire Rune, thanks to Ellen's Rage Rune, which is the next step up from a normal Fire Rune. And all the magic runes have something like this. Yeah, what the hell? Why not file a deception? See if we can get them this. Most of these guys are physical fighters, and I should just blow these guys out of the water. Quite literally, because they're pirates and all. With all these multi-targeting spells that I've got here. Now, if you try to do this, like, as soon as you get your castle, you're probably going to get your ass handed to you. But I'm using very strong characters. I've leveled them up over in the Lorimar region. And Tyr himself is at level 40, so kaboom! This should really blow him out of the water. Like fish shooting fish in the barrel or going dynamite fishing. So, Angie's already gone. And one more round of this and we should be done. I don't know what I was so worried about with all my preparations, but oh, by the way, we got to see Fisherman's Attack a little bit ago. Not that great. They just kind of do like a cross slash from Chrono Trigger, and that's Taihu and Yamku's Unite Attack. And it leaves them unbalanced the next turn. I did manage to sharpen up their weapons and such, but eh. I'm not going to use them after this fight. They're pretty much worthless once I've beaten these guys, but they are pretty hard the first time around. And I think this last explosion should pretty much finish them off. If not, I've got another round of Clone Rune and Fisherman's Attack to wait for these guys. So, yeah, we should pretty much be done. There we go. That took them both out. And that is why I love Alan so much, is because he's got explosion like that. Woohoo! And we win. Not bad, Taiho. Sounds like fun. I understand how you feel. Let's teach those Imperials a lesson. What about you two, Leonardo? Kanik? If you go, we go too. Of course. I think Leonardo's the friendlier one of the two, and Leonardo's the serious one, but they don't really have much of a point in other than being just regular recruits, like most characters in this game. But you can use them if you feel like it, and they'll be usable in war battles too. Even though most war battles are over in like 5 turns at the most, and never really get to use most of my units. Yeah. Anyways, let's go up and rest up after using up all those spells in that fight, and We should be set to go with recruits. I'll probably check Quincy real quick again. And then we'll head off to the Lorimar region and continue with the story. Oh, and I'm going to boot out Taiho and Yamku for Cleo. And I think I'll take Renseal along too. So I'll meet you at the one bridge where Quincy is. We checked and she said that we have a couple more people left to recruit before she will join us as well. So I'll meet you there and see how close we are, and if we can recruit her, we'll recruit her. And Quincy, right now I'm just a hunter, but someday I'll make a name for myself. Can we recruit you? Alright, I'm in. I'm betting on the Liberation Army. Glad to be of service. Alright, so we finally got Quincy. I think she requires 80 recruits, so we should have just enough. I think the pirates just pushed us over the edge, and we finally got enough to recruit her. So, also, by the way, you might have noticed when I was in the menu that instead of Grenseal, I picked Flick to come along instead. For one reason and one reason alone, it's because of the fact that the Warrior's Village, the next town that we're going to go to, is actually his hometown. And I don't know if he has any effect on the story by going there. Oddly enough, he's not required to be in our party when we go there, even though Victor is. So yeah, I'm just going to bring Flick along since it's his hometown and all. So yeah, even though he doesn't really mention it until I think later, or maybe in Suikoden 2. But yeah, we're going to bring Flick along for that very reason, and I'll do some more inventory management. I'll meet you there. Alright, here we are, back in the Warrior's Village, and it's just south of the Gates of Lorimar. I didn't need to really show it on the map, and also I showed it on the map last episode. So, anyways, here we go. Guy named Hicks is talking to his girlfriend, apparently. Don't go, Tengar. Let me go, Hicks. I've already made up my mind. No, you'll get eaten. That's what everyone says. Can you protect me, then? Can you? Wow, your sword isn't even named yet. But the others can, I'm sure. You're always like that. Besides, all that talk of blood-sucking might just be rumors. I might even be comfortable in the castle, better than staying at this backwater village. What are you saying? Uh-oh, here comes old Daddy-O. Caught in the act. Tengar, I told you to stay in the house. You're a bad girl. What if Necklord shows up? What? Did you say Necklord? And Victor butts in. Of all things, that name really sparked him. Hey, old man, did you see Necklord? Who are you people? I'm asking the questions around here. Answer me! Oh, what's gotten into you? Gotten into you, Victor? Calm down. Cleo, my thoughts exactly. Are you with the Liberation Army? That's right, I've seen you attack Milish's castle. I've seen this bear-like man, too. Bear? don't get angry. If you actually look at Victor's official's art, he's like all muscle and like a tiny head. anyways, I see Liberation Army. Then you must be Commander Tyr. I've heard about you. When you come to my house, I'll tell you about Necklord. Please come this way. Ouch, that hurts. Don't pull my arm. You'll pull it out of its socket. Just come. Alright, interesting little band of warriors, because this is a warrior's village after all. This place has got a bit of a rich history, as we might find out pretty soon, but it's not really told in full in this game. But the people of this village actually are quite well renowned for being, well, a village of warriors, after all. This is a warrior's village. And, well, there's a lot of, well, history and lore behind this village. But I'm really not going to go into that too much, aside from the fact that it does get mentioned and the people here have a lot of respect from even as far away places as, you know, places we'll find in other games. And, well, it's got a bit of a reputation. Let's just kind of leave it at that. Anyways, we got a new guy here. Can't recruit him just yet, but remember he's here. My name's Window. I'm not a warrior yet. Actually, I don't even want to be a warrior. I want to build a stained glass window. Kind of an interesting hobby there, but oh well. You're from the Warrior's Village, I guess. Naturally, he's going to need something called a window crystal. We've already recruited someone named Melody that needed a sound crystal, and this guy wants to build a stained glass window. Yeah, and and he's obviously going to need some kind of window crystal. And while the sound crystal will allow us to... I've never actually gone over this before, but when we recruited Melody, her role is to change the sound effects like in menus. So like that duck sound whenever I press whatever gives me like an air message, like... Well, yeah, it changes sounds like that, and you know, accept and confirm sounds, or confirm and cancel sounds whenever you're in the menus. Stuff like that, that's what Melody does, and you bring her these sound set items that we've been finding around the place. Now, I saw someone else there that I could recruit right now, so I'm going to make sure I'm going to save the game, because, well, we're doing some gambling again for like the third time, for third character that we need to recruit. Well, fourth if you count Taiho, but remember this person here? Been a long time since we've seen you. This is Marco. We first met you way back at the beginning of the game in Rockland, and you can actually do use some sort of a little trick to give yourself a lot of money at the very beginning of the game. But now we have Gasper. Marco's role has kind of been I'm just guessing here because I was not paying attention, but Marco's role as a money pit is kind of been thrown to the wayside because of Gasper. But we need to win a total of 5,000 bits from Marco here. And no telling how long this is going to take me with any mistakes I made. I got to really pay attention. So, yeah, I got to make 5,000 bits, as you said. Or is it she? I'm not entirely sure. So, yeah, I'm going to just keep going until I get 5,000 in a profit and then go. Alright, AK Din. Probably the easiest way to do this is actually, instead of trying to get 1,000 at a time, just pick the 10,000 and guess. And if you get it wrong, well, you can leave the menu and go back out and go back in until you get the right amount. It's like a 1 in 3 chance anyways, so eventually you get it if you just kind of leave the menu and go back and hopefully guess right. And that's what I did in order to get Marco there. We got another blacksmith here, finally. Oh, one after another, actually. We just got Moe's, now we got Moose. Howdy, got some work? Liberation? Empire is certainly going down the drain, but a blacksmith is a blacksmith. So I hear Moe's joined up. I believe you need Moe's and I think the other three in your party, but for now, I'm not going to worry about getting him. I don't really need him right now. I think level 12 weapons is pretty good for this point in time in the game, and well, I think he only brings it up to level 15 once you recruit him, which obviously is a good thing and all, but it's not really necessary, except for maybe characters like Victor who rely on his weapon entirely. But you can still get by, so eh, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Maybe later, maybe next time, or between this episode and next one. Or maybe I'll do it midway through here, but for now, let's continue with the story. Hex is so unreliable. Say, will you protect me instead? By the way, I really like Tengar, especially the fact that these two actually come back in the next game. This guy apparently does not. Well, I suppose I should say fortunately. But anyways, let's chit-chat about this Nicklord fellow that Victor apparently knows quite well. It was about 3 months ago a man named Nicklord came here as a general of local Imperial troops. With frightening magical powers, he turned his men into zombies and skeletons. So that's why there were so many graves in the Fortress of Lorimar. He then began threatening the local villages with the zombies. What he demanded was, send Tengar to the castle? No way. That's just like him. If you couldn't guess by name and by behavior at this point, Nicklord is a vampire, of course. And that's why he wants young maidens like Tengar there in order to, you know, join him and be his bride, and he'll have a night of passion and all that, and you know, and then suck him dry and all that. So yeah, bloodsuckers that they are, those vampires. You kind of know the same story with, you know, Dracula and all that. After all, there's a whole Castlevania series, which is made by the same company as, well, Konami, which also makes this game. Either way, back when Konami used to be good and actually made games like this one. Anyways, the other villages gave in to his demands and delivered women, but not us. This is the warrior's village, once we were. Oh my god, oh my god! Uh-oh, here it begins. Apparently they know what's coming up. This village was founded by the chief crusader following the final battle, and we are his descendants. Cliff the Crusader, Anyways, this village has traditionally been defended by the village chiefs. Peace is not always guaranteed. There was a number of times when the village was endangered, and several chiefs went to their clans. Five chiefs became known, and they were... Blah, blah, blah. And this line sums it up quite well. I had a hell of a time. Something to say, he sure likes to talk. That's the line I was looking for. Yes, this guy babbles on like no one's business, even more than me sometimes, even though I'm not much of a babbler outside of these Let's Plays, but oh well. Have you finished your story, old man? You want to hear more? I have another good story. No, that's quite enough, thanks. I'm going to get some rest. I have a room prepared. Get plenty of rest. Perhaps we continue the story tomorrow. Alright. Ooh, Theme of a Moonlit Night is playing in the background. And I've already talked about that back when we were still hanging out with Odessa. The person talking to Hicks right now, that's Cleo, right? No, I'm not interested or anything. Just passing by, that's all. Zoom! There she goes. Don't get any ideas, Hicks. Tengar's your girl. What is it? My ears are pretty beat right now. I'm sorry, Cleo? Cleo? Yes? Why do you fight when you're a woman? Sexist! Women don't fight in the Warriors Village. Why do I fight? No reason why women shouldn't. Just like men, women have things they want to protect. Don't you have something you want to protect? I sure, but I'm weak. You're right, if you're weak, then there's no sense in fighting. No point in getting killed. Well, that's rather blunt, Cleo. But... Hicks, you'll never be strong as long as you consider yourself weak. Also good advice, Cleo. So you kind of turn that around. Guess you're right. Thank you, Cleo. That's alright. Good night, Hicks. Whoa! Master Tier, good night! You said it about as much as I do. So, Cleo, I think she's already off to bed. She's asleep already, even after she just walked in the bed right there. I want to talk to this guy real quick here. Victor and Cleo have already retired. I'll show you your room, Commander Tier. Where do you prefer to talk to the knight? I'm sure he'd love that, but... Victor, what's eating you, buddy? And not Necklord, by the way. Necklord probably prefers women anyways. Tyr, I can't seem to sleep. I finally found Necklord. Necklord isn't human. He misused a rune and became a vampire when he destroyed the village where I was born. Can't wait to go there. And so we get into. When I returned to my village, I saw members of my own family who were turned into zombies by him, eating each other. Ew, that's gruesome. That's where my journey began, and perhaps it will end here. I must destroy him with my own hands. Go to sleep, dear. I'm going to stay up a while and look at the moon. Kind of fitting since we're dealing with vampires and all that, but... Yeah, moon and all that. Good morning, Master Tier. Did you have a good rest? Alright, yeah, I still got my other party members. By the way, I forgot to mention, that's why I brought Alan along. In a long time ago, when Cleo had the fire rune... I decided to switch out the water rune once I got a chance, and this is actually why. It's because Alan tends to become a permanent party member, and Camille as well. I typically tend to give Camille the lightning rune and keep the rage rune on Alan. And there's actually a upgraded version of lightning rune, which I think I can get. I'm not entirely sure if I'm able to get one right now, but I think there's the sirens. Or maybe it's later on, but there's a thunder rune that you get sometime. This is to the point. Let's get to the point. Around this point in time of the game, when you get to like the Kirov region and the Secret Factory and Lorimar, you'll start seeing special runes that can start getting, like the Rage Rune. You can get one pretty soon. And Thunder Rune and some of the stronger spells like the Flowing Rune, which I think we'll get pretty soon, which I'll give to Cleo. That's the level 2 Water Rune, and Thunder is level 2 Lightning Rune. And I might give that, might give one to Flick, I don't know. But I think there's some, like the Banshees or the Sirens or something like that, that drop a Thunder Rune somewhere around this part in time of the game. I don't remember exactly where you can get one, but I might look it up between episodes if I don't find one in like a treasure chest or get one as a random drop or something like that. Either way, we've got unexpected company here. Good morning, everybody. Nick Lord, what do you want? I came to get your daughter, of course. It should be obvious. After all, she's your daughter. I won't let you have Tengger. That's right. Besides, why are you here in broad daylight when you're a vampire? Have you no shame? Have you no ashes? Maybe that's more appropriate since vampires are supposed to turn into ash during the sunlight. Either way, shame, what are you talking about? I became a vampire by using a rune, so I happen to be a well-bred vampire. Besides, the sunlight is no big deal. It does make me a bit sleepy, though. Leave us now, or I'll show you the power of the warrior's village. And yeah, no chance whatsoever. All knocked out. So I've seen. Suppose that's about the best humans can do. Damn you, Necklord, I've got you now. Prepare to die. Victor! And so it's our turn. Basically, all you really do here is lose. And I probably should have hit run since, you know, he's going to dodge pretty much everything we throw at. You cannot win this fight whatsoever. Even if I tried using magic or, you know, special attacks like the clone rune or unit attacks, nothing does anything to this guy. All magic will do like zero damage. All unite attacks will do zero damage because they're not supposed to miss. Stuff like clone runes. Yeah. Nothing works against this guy. And, well, you can see he's wiping out our party. And even though I'm not really trying and all that, well, yeah. You get the point here. And, wow, those water rune pieces are keeping Tyr alive like 3 or 4 turns longer than he should be. Yeah. Well. Wow. Tyr, you are a tank. There we go. Finally. Finally. It took forever. goodness, how famous I've become. That's a tough life. Well, are you satisfied now? Please, give me your daughter. She became the honor of becoming my Wow. Talk about a misogyny. 70 brides. Just you wait. You know, we'll let you take Tengger. Please get out of the way, or would you like to die? No. Then you leave me no choice. Wait, please step aside, Hicks. What are you doing? Protect. Thank you, Hicks, but I can't let you die. Get out of the way, Hicks. She's a lot braver than he is, apparently. I like your style, young lady. If I go with you, do you promise not to harden the villagers? Well, he's kind of already done plenty of that. Of course, you have my word. Tengger, I swear I'll come and rescue you. I'll be waiting for you, Hicks. Shall we be on our way, my pretty bride? Okay, there we go. Have we come to the senses, Tyr? He was right in front of us, and we are powerless. We need a special weapon to defeat him. Most ordinary weapons are useless against vampires, especially runic vampires. So, cue a special sword that we'll be getting pretty soon. got any ideas, village chief here? Zorak. I actually really haven't even mentioned him by name, but I don't think he's even one of the 108 Stars of Destiny. He's just kind of a special character and all that, kind of like the Dwarf Chief way back then. When special weapons against vampires? I don't know. Wait, perhaps that place. What do you have in mind? Yes, west of this village is the Temple of Quon. I don't exactly know if that's the correct pronunciation, but apparently Clone is how I'm going to pronounce it. It's a temple. We've been there once before, actually, in the last episode when we were kind of going out and exploring the world map. This particular temple was founded many years ago by a certain priest named Plone. Arg! I'll pull your tongue out. Just tell us what we need to know. Oh, yes, of course. The Clone Temple is supposed to hide a secret. Victor, you have, I think, a better way of words than this guy does. Boy, that really tells a lot. So, apparently a secret there, but we had no other leads, so let's visit this place. Anyways, let's go. And Moose, I'll try and come back for you later. Let's just get on with the story. And okay, good, I got fully healed. So, let's go. And I could teleport there, but I'm hoping to run into a certain monster, which I still haven't been able to show on screen. I did fight a few of them between episodes when I was grinding tier to hit level 40. But I do want to at least show that guy off at least once. Sometime. But we're already here, so we got one random encounter along the way. I'll try to at least show it at the end of this episode. Maybe go out of my way for all that and all. Yeah. But here we are in the temple. And I totally forgot to get something in the Warrior's Village. I'll be right back. Alright, this is what I wanted to get. Some of these red flower seeds, which you can buy in the Warrior's Village. We got the yellow and blue. I think you can get those in the shops around Milish's area. I'm not entirely sure. But that's just one reason why you want to check every shop as you go through the game. Because, well, obviously it all comes back to your fortress. You can buy them there if you forget what shop to get them at. Anyways, now that we have all three of those flower seeds, talk to this person here. I think we talked to her last time, I believe. I believe her name is Zen. I'm not entirely sure, but yeah. Good. Now I can finish my work here. Thank you so much for the seeds. So you get all three seeds, and she does a little bit more digging and plants them. There we go. Now I'm a member of your party. And Zen has joined us. And unfortunately not really in a state of Zen right now, otherwise I wouldn't be talking. But we've got Temple of Clone, or whatever his place, and we got this guy here, and I'm going to try to pronounce his name right, so it doesn't sound like I'm swearing. Ooh, Starmaster. His name is Fukien, and hopefully I'm not going to pronounce it that much. I'm probably not going to mention it for the random slip of the tongue, but either way, Starmaster, what's that, you know, out here? Of course, Master Tyr is distant leader of the 108 Stars of Heaven and Earth. So apparently this guy knows a lot about the 108 Stars of Destiny, because apparently Tyr is the Star Master. And it's actually a character that I actually like that name. I actually use it as one of my characters in World of Warcraft. But oh well, 108 Stars. Cleo, this priest is bonkers. But we've been recruiting characters all along the way and all that. Victor, you were born on the Star of Heavenly Loneliness, and Cleo under the Star of Heavenly Fulfillment. All born on the signs of the 108 stars, as I was myself. You're all distant, together, once again, under Master Tyr's sign, the Star of Heavenly Guidance. That's enough babbling, old man. Now listen to what we have to say. I already know, you've come here to find out how to destroy the Necklard the Vampire, correct? Well, he's rather knowledgeable for an old monk, and for breaking the fourth wall a lot, but either way. Then you know a way? Yes, I do. Please follow me. And so we got a free recruit right then there. What's this, an altar? This is the entrance to the Cave of the Past. What you're looking for is in there. If you knew where you're coming, why didn't you make preparations? Probably because you didn't want anyone to get in there without him knowing. Mr. Tyr, much awaits to this cave. You must be ready to accept it all. Please go in and be sure to watch yourselves. Alright, so, please be very careful. Alright, so, and one step in and we run into a random battle. If you don't want to grind out in the world map till I hit level 40, this place works a lot better. I just kind of wanted to make sure to take care of it before this episode. Because I kind of talked a lot about recruiting Aikai in the past, and well, I get to let that conversation rest for now. Yeah, auto battle, we're going to kill some of these things, and I do want to level up a little bit in here, because Well, you saw how Necklord wiped the floor with this, and even with the special item that allows us to damage him, well, let's just say we're going to need all levels we can get, even the ones we can get from high-level monsters inside Necklord's castle. But yeah, this is a pretty good place to... Ooh. I do not like these banshees. And we might see why in just a moment. Thankfully, they're easy to kill, but if they appear in the back row, you want to focus fire on them and use things like Black Shadow or Hell, because they can do some damage that you don't really want to deal with, especially in a long cave like this one. And admittedly, I could have gotten a rune out of Warrior's Village. I saw it in the item shop. There's actually a rune in there called the Champion's Rune, and if you're stronger than the random or the average level of random monsters around here, well, it pretty much is like no encounters. And if you have that equipped, but I'm going to bring along these party members because we got a bunch of strong runes. And yeah, something I forgot to mention is that I don't have a Holy Rune character on me anymore because I booted out Yamku. And, of course, Grimio is no longer with us. But I think I remember this cave pretty well because I've actually been... In all the times I played through this game, this is probably the cave I have to go through the most. Simply because there's a bunch of hidden items in here. In addition to a recruit that you can't recruit until you get close to 100 Stars of Destiny or so. So, yeah. Or whatever it takes to get castle level 4. But yeah, we're just going to kind of level up. I kind of want to get to the point where I can let go of these monsters. Simply doesn't make it that much easier. But there are a couple hidden items in here that are required for getting a few recruits. And if I remember right, that leads to a treasure chest. And I'm going to fight this in. Good thing we got that hell spell, because this will make this fight a bit easier, and, well, I don't want those banshees to get an attack in. That's all I'm saying. But I'll probably have to show it eventually to show why I'm so worried about that. Anyways, boo! I don't know why I decided to make the sound effect there and fail horribly. But yeah. Yeah, we're going up and up in level. Yeah, I did, like 50 fights or so out in the world map of Lorimar before this, I started doing this episode because I wanted to get recruit Aikai and all that. Oh, there we go. The Flowing Crystal. That is the level 2 water magic, and I want to give that to Cleo because it'll make the fight with Necklord so much easier, you wouldn't believe it. Alright, there we go. She didn't get an attack. But yeah, having a strong water magic rune and putting it on a character like Cleo, yeah, having drops of kindness, which heals like 300 hit points to your entire party, that just helps immensely with the Necklord fight. And, well, alright, so we got a bit of a cave there, a bit of a hidden secret. There's the window crystal that we need to use to recruit Window. And that little passageway that you really can't see, it's kind of like you go down, hit right or so, then go down some more. It's mostly a straight path, but, you know, you kind of got to go a little bit to right and feet away. It's like the first time we've seen something like that since Torin Castle. Yeah, before we fought the zombie dragon way back at the beginning of the game when, well, Taiho himself was a required party member and we didn't actually have the ability to change party members at that point in time in the game because we haven't actually established our headquarters at that time in the game. But I'm going to let these guys go. I don't want to fight that battle. And my level's pretty high as it is. These golems are a little bit too high level for me still, so I'm going to keep fighting them and they're not that dangerous. They do have that move that attacks my entire party, but I have Cleo for that, and I still haven't gotten anyone near fatal status, so we're still pretty good at well-to-do with some of those fights. And yeah, like I said, I've memorized this place pretty well. I don't think I've gone off the wrong way yet. Got an old book, Volume 2 there. And I think we still need Hugo in order to make use of those old books. I've neglected to give all the war paints, or just the various different colors of paints, to Ivanov. We recruited him last episode in Milish's castle. Once you beat Milish, you can go recruit him there, and then you can give him all your paints, and you'll make essentially what's going to be the Japanese cover for the Japanese box art for the game, and you can view it here in game. But anyways, yes, I know about this guy. We can't recruit him yet, but his name is Crowley. Mr. Crowley, what goes on in your head? Ozzy Osbourne, if you didn't know that song. But yeah, it's kind of, you gotta feel your way around again. But he doesn't, you can't actually recruit him until you have like 100 stars of destiny or so. So you're gonna have to come back. You can't possibly have that many by this point in time in the game. So yeah. Oh, War Scroll, that's what we need to get Hugo. So we're gonna do some recruiting later. Well, maybe at the start of next episode, because I'm already up to 49 minutes in this recording, and well, I think once we get through the Key of the Past, we'll call it a day. But for now, we're just gonna get through and get the item or sword. Well, I probably should say we're getting a sword at the end of this place, and Victor's gonna replace his weapon with said sword. It's gonna be his permanent weapon for the rest of the game. But yeah, that's what we're going in here to get, and it's going to be a special sword that we use to defeat Necklord, of course. As he hinted kind of back in Warrior's Village, we need a special weapon to beat Necklord and all that, yada yada yada. So, no surprise, we're getting a sword for Necklord Victor, and conveniently enough, it's, well, a sword. which you're going to replace his Coden sword, and conveniently, it's no sprite changes are going to be necessary once we get in battle and all that. So yeah, lazy developers, Victor's going to look exactly the same in battle, and, well, as he has throughout the entire game. So, well, let's let go. Still not high enough to let go of a battle full of just the golems. Silver lead, I think that's... Actually, I think anyone equipped that... what I'm thinking of right now is like necklace items, which only kobolds can equip. So, but for silverlets, I think most people can equip those. There are certain types of items that only certain races of characters can equip. Like in Suikoden 2, you're gonna get the wingers. Don't give up. There are gonna be some winged people in. Suikoden 2, and they can only equip the winged ornaments and stuff, so yeah. Headgear, can anyone equip that? No. So if there's something in your place, overloaded, give up that headgear. I want the Mega Missing. I just want to loot every single. I just want to loot every single treasure chest that's in here so I don't forget about it later. I'm kind of one of those completionist type people who doesn't like to throw anything away or opens up all treasure chests and all that. Which kind of is kind of ironic because I just threw something away to get something from a treasure chest, but getting all the treasure chest contents is more important to me. got another golem, kill you real quick. And Cleo got a nice critical hit there and killed him. Woohoo! Alright. And I think we got the headgear, by the way, from a random battle, if not from a treasure chest. But it will. I think we're almost there. I think actually in the next room we'll get the sword that we need. Yep. Oh, here we are. Same room. This must be what the old man warned us about. Don't get too close to it. No problem. Don't worry. He who awakens me, be cursed. It's called the Star Dragon Sword. What? Hey, looks like it's the Black Shadow spell. And it's sucking us in! Okay. Alright. It threw us into some strange village. Since this is the key of the past, I wonder where we are. Ouch, what is this place? Who knows? Looks like we got thrown out of the key thanks to you know who. Hey, we made it alive, didn't we? Let's go, let it go. Alright, locked door! Locked door! Oh, a little boy! He looks kind of familiar, and he runs away. Locked door, so we can't actually go anywhere right now. Alright, who are you, little boy? Oh, Ted, are you the people who came to take away the treasure? What treasure? Good, I didn't think so. Grandpa looked real angry, so I was worried. Ted, come here. Yes, Grandpa. Mr. Deer, did you see Ted? He did remind me of Ted. What's going on? I don't know, but that sword kind of screwed us over. Okay, now we can go inside the house. And it's very important that you explore this place as fully as you possibly can. Because there are some items you cannot get once you leave here. So yes, lots of visible in this little town that we're in. Either way, let's talk to old Grandpa here. Were you people sent by that woman? What woman? Messengers? What are you talking about? So you have nothing to do with her. With who? If you don't, then you must leave this place immediately. Come, Ted. Wait, Grandpa, I want to talk to those people. Come with me! Okay, insolent boy! Alright, so... we're obviously not going to heed his warning. Don't give up. I'm just going to toss another Mega Medicine for that. Oh, Mega Medicine. Alright, so... What's wrong? Is there something on my face? Are you still here? We don't want strangers here. What are you so afraid of? Are you afraid of that woman you mentioned? That woman? Rather rude way to speak to someone, don't you think? Uh-oh. It's Windy and Necklord together! Windy, what are you doing in this place? Damn you, Necklord! How dare you come here? By the way, Cleo, what is this place? Who cares? I like her attitude. What's your business here, Windy? Village Chief, I came all the way out here because you refused to give me the rune. You should thank me for making the effort. Now I'll give me the Soul Eater. I've never heard of such a thing. Don't bother to lie to me. I happen to know this is the Village of the Hidden Rune. Hey, Cleo, let's remember that. The Village of the Hidden Rune. Village of the Hidden Rune. A boy named Ted. Soul Eater that they just mentioned a second ago. I think I know where we are. Probably the past, because this is the cave of the past. Did you see that, Chief? Well, you were in denial. Uber got bored. Oh, Uber. Interesting character, but one whose details never really get fleshed out too much in this series. But we'll be seeing a lot of him, especially in Suikoden 3. Give me the room, or else this village will be charred beyond recognition. Damn you, are you that eager to see this cursed power of the Soul Eater? Oh, Soul Eater, Cursed Rune, show your power and strike the enemy. Oh, he's got the same thing that I do. I wonder where we are. It should be obvious. I don't know if we're using Black Shadow or Hell or some other spell we don't yet have, but... Wow. Blast her away and teleport us away at the same time. Okay, so we're safe. Travelers, I'm sorry to have involved you in this business. No kidding. Ted, come here. Yes, Grandpa. Give me your right hand. That's right. Stay still, Ted. Well, Soul Eater, rune of life and death. I believe that's actually the full name of the rune. Not Soul Eater. I think Soul Eater is more of a nickname. I think the actual proper name for the Soul Eater is a true rune of life and death. Which, like I've said before, I think I've talked about this before. We really haven't seen the whole life part of the Soul Eater. Which, well, we see the death part a lot, and, well, it eats souls and all that and grows in power, and that's why we got three spells now. Anyway, He's giving the Soul Eater to Ted here, and he's like, depart my body and give this boy your party. Alright, so this is how Ted originally came to acquire the Soul Eater. And if it wasn't obvious by now, this is 300 years in the past when Ted was a boy, and then he wandered the world for 300 years until he found us and became friends and then passed on the Soul Eater to Tyr. And it's just one convoluted time travel mess. If you kind of haven't gotten the hint anyways. But anyways, Grandpa, what's this? Forgive me, Ted. I'm afraid I pass on a sorrowful fate unto you. Remember, the power of this rune must never be unleashed. Travelers, up ahead is a secret path which leads to the village outskirts. Take Ted, this child, and run. I'll get Wendy's attention and act as a decoy. Let's go, Ted. Okay, Grandpa, well, you'll come later. That's right, you must hurry now. And I forget which way I'm supposed to go. You may have noticed a treasure chest down below. But I think that's where we're going to go. Anyways, this is you over here. Lady Wendy sure is a warrior. Instead of being around the bush, why don't we just burn down this village? yes, he's a bit sadistic, if you couldn't tell. I just followed my orders and stayed on guard, and look who's coming. Just a child and some cowards. What did you say? Keep your distance from him, Victor. This one's tough. Yes, I know. He's not human. Even at this distance, I can feel his terrible power. So you understand my power, do you? Well then, don't bother to struggle against my sword. I'll chop you all into little pieces, making sure you feel no pain. Damn. And that was kind of a weird graphical glitch. I don't know if that'll actually show up in the recording, but it kind of just kind of went all over the place with the little white lines and all that. Either way, hey, Uber, Lady Wendy wants you. That old man escaped into the forest. Necklord, you again. I'm very busy right now. I'll take you on some other time. Alright, so, anyways, looks like we're safe. Yes, and that fire in the village is dying down too. But I don't know what happened to the villagers, aside from the obvious. What happened to Grandpa? Ted, I'm afraid you're going to have to depend on yourself from now on. Do you understand? Mr. Tyr, this is definitely the Ted we know. We must be in the past. The past? The Star Dragon's sword curse threw us back into the past? Well, we were obviously in the cave of the past, but... connect the dots, Victor. It's pretty obvious now. Probably what just happened was the incident from 300 years ago that Ted mentioned. And from this moment on, Ted must journey alone for 300 years. In any case, we must find a way to return to the present. You're right. Hey, Tyr, what's that light? Isn't that where we first came out? I agree, let's go back to that place. But first, we must loot and pillage this village. And I think if we go back to where we met Uber, we can get the item that's in the treasure chest. And I believe it's actually a free boar rune, if not mistaken. Yes, it's a boar crystal, actually. Don't give up. Let's get rid of one of those mega medicines. Alright, and I'm probably going to give up another mega medicine. If I remember right, there's one more item in this village, and we saw it kind of blocked by a lady who was kind of standing in one of the houses. But you want to... At this point, you can get everything in the village, and pretty much... I think there's just that one other chest right here. Champions... Oh, that's the one I was talking about before. That's the crystal that allows you to... negate all random encounters. So yeah, you want to make sure you get that. And let's check this one last house for good measure. I don't think there's anything in here, but better safe than sorry. And if we go up here, we'll go back to our own time, of course. Maybe if we enter here, we can return to the present. Could be. That's a pretty good idea coming from you. Oh, leave me alone. Tyr, what shall we do with the kid? Regardless of what you pick, you cannot bring Ted along. Ted remains in his own time, regardless of whether we take him along or not. We can't take him along. Ted, you're going to have to live on your own for a very long time. And at the end of your voyage, I suppose it would be wrong to change his fate. No, actually we can't tell him the future since we are from there, but we already know. You're leaving me? What should I do? Please take me with you. Ted, you must be strong. Never give up and don't tell anybody about the rune on your right hand. Okay. Victor, we'd better get going. We don't know when this light will fade. Yeah, if you try to go through and bring him along, he'll be left behind either way. We just teleport back to our own time. And, well, Ted won't be brought along with us. I don't know. Either way, boy, were we lucky. I guess we made it back. Alright, so we now have the Star Dragon Sword, in just a moment, obviously. Let's see again. Stay clear of everyone. We don't want to go through that again. Listen to Mr. Expert. You got us into that mess in the first place. Victor. I didn't do anything. Victor, don't you have an important mission? That's right. I'm going to kill that Neck Lord. I was just getting tired of sleeping. I'll join you on your mission. Pull me out. What's with this thing? Pretty arrogant for a sword. If you don't want to, fine, but you'll never defeat the vampire. Okay. I mean, yes, sir. Let's go, partner. Why should a sword call me partner? So, yes, it's a talking sword, and it has its moments throughout the series, but I think we're pretty much done here. I got an escape talisman for this very reason. I think I've been carrying that thing around since the very beginning of the game, but very convenient. We went all the way outside of the cave, and now we're back seeing the sunlight. And I kind of want to have that another escape crystal on tier. I still had one on Victor for who knows how long. But we can now go and fight Necklord if we so desire. But I think I'm going to end the episode off here. Headed back home to base. And I'll probably bring along some of the blacksmiths to recruit Moe's. And we'll do some more recruiting at the beginning of the next episode. And then head off to Necklord's castle. We've already kind of been there at the end of the last episode when we're just kind of exploring the area. But it's just south of the warrior's village. So yeah. It's the only other place in that region of the world. So, yeah, if you have the world map and by recruiting Templeton and all that, well, by process of elimination, you know where to go. Anyways, we're going to sleep and save and, well, call it a day. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.